Hey guys, it's Project Dave playing some Monster Hunter Rise for PS5. It's a little early in the morning, so my voice might be kind of soft. I know it tends to be soft anyway. But we did the HR7 promotion quest here. It's much easier than the HR6 promotion quest because that one functions as like a block, like a gear slash skill block. So your gear or your skill must be above a certain level to get past this point. So that is forcing only good players, basically, or only geared players, to be at HR7 presently. This isn't going to be the case forever, but at least for the time being, seems like HR7 and up, it's going to be smooth sailing in multiplayer because of the general competence of the player base. I do have to get wide range at some point. Like max out wide range and then a bunch of healing stuff so that we can heal people. That's the best thing to do in multiplayer for the really, really difficult stuff that like one-shots the whole screen or almost one-shots the whole screen is to get healing. This is the best way to fight like Arch Zeno, whatever. And which I don't think very many people have done in multiplayer, period. It's mostly done in solo. And the Behemoth as well. The Behemoth, you have to know the mechanics too, but because a lot of it just one-shots you. Or, I mean, it doesn't even one-shot you, it one-shots like half the map. Good old Behemoth. But there's no Behemoth in this game, at least so far. So, and that's just a crossover. Ancient Leshen was a little different. Like damage-wise, but you definitely had to sit there and heal a lot to make sure it worked out. But this guy looked interesting. I think I remember the wedding dress style armor. The corset is nice, but I'm not super keen on the rest of it. But we've got an Argacuga chest. I think the Rathalos chest is the best one that I have access to right now, but I don't have the gear for it. Or I don't have the mats to make it, so we'll go with Nargacuga, which is totally fine. And it looks cool. Looks better than the Rathalos chest, so. Aside from pants and boots, and I guess gloves, but I like the innate part of the chest instead of gloves. Tends to look better. And we still got our silly hat on. How's that? So I'm not super scared of anything remaining at this point. Also, it's going to be hard to find people to play multiplayer in the event quests because there's 60 different event quests once you get past 7. So that's going to split up the player base, and there's just not very many people there to begin with because it's only been a couple days. But I will try to get Akuma and use a heavy bowgun with Akuma, because that's just what you do, that's honorable. Besides, we know how to combat. I did the same thing with Ryu and Sakura in Monster Hunter World. So if you want to go back and look at those videos, they're pretty funny. So, same idea. This mining route is good for getting fire cell stone, which I needed to make my weapon. Seems like 210 is the attack power on the weapon. That seems like it's very high. It is the end of the tree, so I can't upgrade them further, so I'm gonna have to switch to something else. I think the main thing I'm looking at, I need to do the Assassin's Creed style of expedition missions and then pray to RNGesus to get the right mats. There's no way to farm them, so we'll see whenever I get those. But this weapon seems totally fine, and my defense is very high, so I don't even get close to getting one shot anymore. That doesn't mean the big boy elder dragons won't do it, but they might not be in the game yet, I'm not sure. Like the super juiced versions of them. Anyway, thanks for watching. This is a good fight, and it's a fun enemy that looks really weird and has two heads and whatever. And a bloodborne level of numbers of attacks. This thing's got like 30 attacks. But enjoy. Thanks for watching.
Move. complete.
Yeah, move!
Wait. Too blunt.
Ha! Indeed.
Oh,